जय हिंद फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू रॉयल्स एजुकेशन। फाइनली एंड अनफॉर्चुनेटली कोविड-19 हैज लैंडेड इन इंडिया। देर आर 39 कन्फर्म केसेज इन इंडिया। इन फैक्ट देर इज़ अ लॉकडाउन इन ऑल ओवर इंडिया बिकॉज ऑफ दिस कोविड-19, दैट इज कोरोना वायरस डिजीज 19। ऑब्वियसली दिस लॉकडाउन इज अ गुड आइडिया टू कंटेन दिस आउटब्रेक, बट WHO, दैट इज वर्ल्ड हेल्थ ऑर्गेनाइजेशन, विच इज एन UN स्पेशलाइज एजेंसी and which looks after control and manages world health issues, has still not declared COVID-19 as a pandemic. So why? Let's understand this a little. We will know endemic, epidemic and pandemic. What are these? First, endemic. A disease that exists in a particular region is called endemic. Thereafter comes the epidemic, when outbreak of a disease happens and it happens to many people and in many regions, in many communities at the same time, it's called epidemic. And lastly comes the pandemic. But when this epidemic becomes global and spreads throughout the world, it is called pandemic. So WHO has not declared COVID-19 a pandemic yet. WHO has issued some guidelines to contain the outbreak of COVID-19, which is applicable and must be followed globally by every individual. In this video, Megha Singh Rathore has compiled the guidelines of the WHO on the topics as given, symptoms of COVID-19, myths but say in this regard, as over social media, many myths, better say rumors, have spread over COVID-19. Safety precaution and prevention against this deadly disease. And lastly, the mask discipline means who, when, how to use, put on and dispose of a mask. I have already made this video in Hindi. You can get link in description box. I have made two videos about coronavirus outbreak, one each in Hindi and English. That link is also given in description box. You can very well visit and see. I have also made a video on WHO, that's UN specialized agency, rather say a complete playlist on United Nations. Get the link in the description box and you can see it there. With this much of introduction, let's start with the symptoms of COVID-19. So the symptoms of coronavirus, COVID-19, we will see. So before I say about the symptoms, let's understand a little that coronavirus is a group of viruses whose genetic material is enveloped inside a protein spiked corona. Means you can say the formation is like crown. That's why the name coronavirus has been given. The two severe already beings, that is SARS coronavirus in China, which happened, this outbreak happened in 2003, and MERS-CoV, which outbreak was there in Saudi Arabia in 2012. So there has already been six type of coronaviruses. It was first identified in 1956. Now in 2019 December, this seventh coronavirus outbreak happened in Wuhan city of China, which is a live animal, or you may say a international animal market. Its name is nCoV-19, means novel coronavirus because of its new structure, or you may call it COVID-19. I will write here COVID-19. It is zoonotic, means it spreads through animals to human as the process of spillover. It attacks mainly on respiratory system and sometimes on gastrointestine. Its symptoms are, first, means if you see the common symptoms, it's fever, dry cough develops after 2 to 7 days, mild breathing difficulties at the outset, means when it will start, the mild breathing difficulty will be there, gastrointestinal issues, diarrhea and general body ache. When it becomes severe, so there will be high fever exceeding 100.4 degree Fahrenheit, pneumonia or kidney failure. About this mild breathing difficulty, if you want to check yourself that whether you are having this, means whether you are infected or not, so one doctor from Thailand has given a very good check of this, means you try to hold your breath for more than 10 to 12 seconds. If you are able to hold with no difficulty, that means you are not infected. So this is about coronavirus symptoms. Transmission as coughs or sneezes from infected person or touching contaminated objects. You need to be away from from a person who is already infected or to anyone who coughs or sneezes at least 1 meter away. 1 meter, because these viruses, when a person coughs or sneezes, comes out from his mouth or nose through a tiny droplets and lands on your body parts or somewhere on the object. If you touch that contaminated object and thereafter you touch your nose, your eyes, nose and mouth, so you will be infected. So this is the symptoms of coronavirus. Now we will understand the myths. Over the social media, there has been lot of talks and lot of wrong things which is there. Means somebody, even on the news channel, they are saying that you should be using that UV dryer. Sometimes it's that you should consume alcohol like this. So I will, means through the WHO guidelines, what they say, that what is the factual things, I will bust every myth in this regard. So let's start. Can spraying alcohol or chlorine all over your body kill the virus, kill the new coronavirus? Spraying alcohol or chlorine over your body will not kill viruses that have already entered your body. Of course, the alcohol or chlorine kills the viruses, but the viruses which has already entered inside your body will not be killed. So spraying such substances over your body or your clothes can damage your clothes or mucous membrane, that is your eyes and mouth. So never do it. Then, are hand dryers effective in killing the new coronavirus? No. WHO clearly says no. Hand dryers are not effective in killing the 2019 nCoV, means COVID-19. So to protect yourself against the new coronavirus, you should frequently clean your hands with a alcohol based hand rub or wash them with soap and water. That is only the method. Thereafter comes that whether the coronavirus spreads through the mosquito bites or not. Still, there is no information or evidence to suggest this, that this spreads through the mosquito bites. Means if the mosquito bites someone who is infected, thereafter it bites someone who is not infected, it may be injecting the blood which it has sucked from the infected person. So there is no evidence that through the mosquito bite it is spreading. Then comes, can pets at home spread the new coronavirus 2019 nCoV? Pets, there is no evidence that it spreads through the companions, pets such as dogs and cats, but still you should be keeping them at least away, and whenever you handle them or touching them or you give them food, wash your hands with the alcohol based hand rub or soap and water. Then comes, do vaccines against pneumonia protect you against the new coronavirus? There is no evidence in this regard, but the symptoms of pneumonia, if you are there in the hospital, symptoms of pneumonia can be treated through vaccine of pneumonia. Then, can eating garlic help prevent infection with the new coronavirus? Yesterday, someone told me that you eat garlic and it will prevent infection of the new coronavirus. Garlic is a healthy food that may have some antimicrobial properties. But however, there is no evidence that it is able to contain the outbreak of this nCoV 2019. Then comes, can regularly rinsing your nose with saline help prevent infection with the new coronavirus? There is no evidence again, though if you clean your nose with the saline, it will help your nasal congestion and it will be helpful, but there is no evidence that if you are already infected, it will stop or kill the viruses of corona. Then comes the antibiotics, whether they are effective in preventing and treating the new coronavirus. Again, antibiotics do not work against viruses, only it works against only bacteria. But if you have been identified with a few symptoms of the coronavirus, and if you go to the medical center or go to a hospital, the doctor might give you the antibiotic to contain the bacterial co-infection. Does the new coronavirus affect older people, or are younger people also susceptible? So I must tell you that people of all ages can be infected by the new coronavirus nCoV 2019. दो ओल्डर पीपल विच हैव प्री एग्जिस्टिंग मेडिकल कंडीशन सच एज अस्थमा, डायबिटीज, हार्ट डिजीज अपीयर्स टू बी मोर वल्नरेबल, बट एवरीबडी एज पर द WHO एडवाइस एंड गाइडलाइंस मस्ट टेक द गिवन प्रिकॉशन एंड प्रोटेक्शन अगेंस्ट दिस डेडली वायरस. आर देयर एनी स्पेसिफिक मेडिसिन टू प्रिवेंट और ट्रीट द न्यू कोरोना वायरस? स्टिल देर इज नो स्पेसिफिक मेडिसिन रिकमेंडेड टू प्रिवेंट और ट्रीट द न्यू कोरोना वायरस दैट इज 2019 एंड को, और यू कॉल इट COVID-19, बट स्टिल द सिम्टम्स कैन बी ट्रीटेड. द WHO और मैनी मेडिकल एजेंसीज और अराउंड द ग्लोब दे आर मैनी मेडिकल एक्सपर्ट्स विच आर ऑलरेडी देयर इन मेकिंग ऑफ द स्पेसिफिक मेडिसिन. वेदर, कोल्ड वेदर एंड स्नो कैन किल द न्यू कोरोना वायरस? So this question, you might feel that the snow or cold weather can kill this coronavirus, but means as per the presumption that viruses lies on the middle line of the live and dead. Whenever they find the conducive environment, they attack. Means they cannot survive in the very cold or very hot. But as of now, there are no regions or no evidence that the new coronavirus can be controlled by cold weather or snow. Why? Because the normal human body temperature remains around 36.5 degrees centigrade and 37 degrees centigrade, which is very much conducive for the viruses, irrespective of the temperature outside, whether it is snowy or whether it is too much cold or whether it is too much hot. So the viruses lives inside your body, and that too means inside your respiratory system where the temperature is already 36.5 degrees centigrade or 37 degrees centigrade. So there is nothing to believe that cold weather and snow can kill the new coronavirus. Again, taking a hot bath does not prevent the new coronavirus disease, because the temperature inside your body and just outside remains 36.5 degrees centigrade to 37 degrees centigrade. So if you take a hot bath, it might kill the coronaviruses or any microbial agents over your body, but it will not get inside your body. That means the coronaviruses can still live inside your respiratory tract or inside your body. So it will not help. Again, the new coronavirus cannot be transmitted through goods manufactured in China or any country reporting COVID-19 cases. Many of the business has been hit because of this coronavirus. Why? Because the other countries which were importing items from the China or Southeast Asia, they have stopped doing so. I will tell you that this coronavirus doesn't last long. Means, and if you buy some items and if that item is shipped from China or Southeast Asia, that means it will be there in travel through days. So if it comes to you, disinfect that packet, thereafter open it, and means nothing will happen, means it will not get you infected. And how effective are thermal scanners in detecting people infected with the new virus? I must say you that thermal scanners are effective in detecting people who have developed a fever. Means a thermal scanner can only detect your higher body temperature. But many of the people who have been identified with the COVID-19 have not shown the symptoms of high fever for more than 14 days. So if somebody is already infected and if he is going through thermal scanner and if he is not having fever, he will not be caught. Then can ultraviolet disinfection lamp kill the new coronavirus? Means it may decontaminate the object, but if you feel that you can expose yourself to this ultraviolet disinfection lamp, it may sterilize your hands or other area of the skin, but with this means it will not go inside your body and will kill inside your respiratory system, means whatever if it contains the coronavirus disease or COVID-19. And UV lamps can even harm you because the UV radiation can cause skin irritations. Then, protection and prevention of COVID-19. we will see that what are the WHO guidelines in this regard, how we can protect ourselves, and we can take the prevention against this COVID-19. So the first is, wash your hands with soap and running water when hands are visibly dirty, or whether hands are visibly dirty or not, frequently clean them by using alcohol based hand rub or soap and water. Next, protect yourself and others from getting sick. How you can protect yourself and others from getting sick? First, the main idea is in protection and prevention of this COVID-19 is washing your hands. When? After coughing or sneezing, when caring for the sick, before, during, and after you prepare the food, before eating, before toilet use, when hands are visibly dirty, and after handling animals or animal waste. Then protect others from getting sick. How you can do that? When coughing and sneezing, cover mouth and nose with flexed elbow or tissues. As soon as you have used the tissues, throw that tissue in a closed bin immediately after use. Then clean hands with alcohol based hand rub or soap and water after coughing or sneezing and when caring for the sick. Then protect others from getting sick. How you can do that? Avoid close contact if you are yourself experiencing cough and fever. So better don't get in close contact with someone else. Avoid spitting in public, means do not spit in public. Then if you have fever, cough and difficulty breathing, do seek the medical care. And when you go to the doctor, just share your medical history and your travel history, so that he can identify that at what places you have traveled, whether there is an outbreak of those places. If you are being identified with coronavirus, that district or that state administration can be alerted. That means a person has visited this place and he is having coronavirus. So the required prevention and protection against this disease can be taken there also. Then practice food safety. How? Use different chopping boards and knives for raw meat and cooked foods. Wash your hands between handling raw and cooked food. Then again, practice food safety. Sick animals and animals that have died of disease should not be eaten. If you find if you are going to buy some meat, do not buy a meat where the animal is already dead, or do not eat something which is already dead. Then practice food safety. Even in areas experiencing outbreak, you can still buy meat products. It's very much on social media that do not eat meat, do not eat milk product, but it is nothing like so. Just cook it well, cook it at a very high temperature, clean it thoroughly, thereafter cook it. Means you can do this and properly handle it, thereafter you can eat even milk products and non-veg. Then soaping in wet markets in China and Southeast Asia, if you are doing this, stay healthy. How you can do that? Wash hands with soap and water after touching animals and animal products. Avoid touching eyes, nose and mouth. Avoid contact with sick animals and spoiled meat. Avoid contact with stray animals, waste and fruits in market. So if you have gone there in China, wet markets, or in Southeast Asia, do all these things. Wash hands properly, avoid touching eyes, nose and mouth every now and then. Just make a habit, don't miss, never do this. Avoid contact with sick animals and spoiled meat. So do all these things. And thereafter, if you are in travel, how you can stay healthy? Avoid travel if you have a fever and cough. If you have this, seek medical attention and do share your travel and medical history to your doctor. Avoid close contact with the people suffering from a fever and cough. Frequently clean hands by using alcohol based hand rub or soap and water. Avoid touching eyes, nose or mouth. Then eat only well cooked food. Avoid spitting in public. Avoid close contact with and travel with animals that are sick. Again, When coughing and sneezing, cover your mouth and nose with flex elbow. As soon as or tissues, as soon as you have used the tissues, immediately throw it inside a closed bin. If you choose to wear a mask, be sure to cover mouth and nose and avoid touching mask once it's on. Immediately discard single-use mask after each use and wash hands after removing mask. If you become sick while traveling, inform crew and seek early medical attention. And do share your travel history to your doctor. Then we will know about the mask discipline in the market nowadays, in anywhere, wherever there is a rumor or reality of outbreak of the COVID-19. If you go in the market, you may not find the mask, because the WHO itself says that because of the fear of this disease, the mask is almost, the people who need it and people who don't need it have already taken the mask from the market. So, but the WHO says that you use the mask, but there are some do's and don'ts, means who should use it, who should not, how to put on, everything. So we will understand this one by one. When to use a mask? For healthy people, wear a mask. So if you are healthy, first of all, you should not wear a mask. And you should wear if you are taking care of a person with suspected COVID-19 infection. And if you are coughing or sneezing, do wear a mask. And masks are effective only when, before putting on, clean your hands with soap and water or alcohol based rub. Then if you wear a mask, then you must know how to use it and dispose of it properly. Then we will know completely about how to put on, use, take off and dispose of a mask. So let's start. So before putting on a mask, clean hands with the alcohol based hand rub or soap and water, means you must wash your hands first. Then put on the mask, cover mouth and nose with mask and make sure there are no gaps between your face and the mask, because if it is so, there is no need of, means there is a no benefit of putting the mask on. When you have wear it, just press it over your nose so that tightened portion will just fit your nose curves. Thereafter, avoid touching the mask while using it. If you do, clean your hands with the alcohol based hand rub or soap and water. Why it is so? Because you have put on the mask and that mask over it suppose has contaminated with the COVID-19 disease. If you put your hands over this, your hands will also be contaminated. After you remove it, and if you touch your eyes, nose or mouth with your contaminated hands, you may get infected. So never touch the mask if you are wearing it. Then replace the mask with a new one as soon as it is a damp, and do not reuse single use mask. Thereafter, to remove the mask, remove it from the behind, do not touch the front of the mask, discard immediately in a closed bin, do not throw it here and there. Clean hands with alcohol based hand rub or soap and water. So this was everything about what are the symptoms and what are the myths about this COVID-19, and what are the myth busters, how to take precaution, prevention, and how to protect yourself against this deadly virus. Thereafter, if you are putting on the mask, what are the mask discipline. So this video had everything. I hope you have liked this video. Please do share, do subscribe to Royals Education. Stay healthy. Thank you.